Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today we're going to answer a 0x88 error. If you look inside your printer on the printer rail, you're going to see a little sensor like this. It is called a PIS sensor because it's right below the printhead carriage. And there are lots of times you get a drop of ink on it and damage it. This sensor is called a PIS sensor, a photo ink sensor. So it emits light from one of the node and the receiving light from the other node and measure the resistance. And the error code just tell you what could be wrong. For example, it could be the sensor doesn't turn on at all, or the sensor cannot emit enough light, or the sensor emits enough light but not receiving the correct return. The same error code is used from WF36 something to about 76 something, for example 7610. And things can affect this. One is you have a drop of ink on it. Another one, maybe you are printing with your lid open, so the outside light interferes with the light inside. This little spring, I don't know what it's for, and it seems useless. I mean, I have a printer come with it. Somehow I remove it. Never really bother me at all. You're supposed to have a number one screwdriver bit and a number two screwdriver bit, but actually number one work for both screw size, so just get number one. See, if you remove this, you can see the little spring go with it, so don't worry about that spring. Now we're going to work on the right side of the printer, and you want to slide the printhead carriage all the way to the left, so you will have a flexibility on the right. You can see I cannot do much here because the printhead carriage is in the way. Let me take this this part out and just show you. So this metal cover, you just slide to your right, see that, and now you can just lift it up and open it. If you need a whole star wheel with a PIS sensor, you can just go to bchtechnology.com and just search for star. And this one we're going to work at 36, 40, 36, 20. This is the star wheel. And it will tell you it has the PIS sensor installed. Today we're going to only replace the PIS sensor. So for example, if you have a WF 7610 or like or WF 7711, that we don't sell the whole star wheel with the sensor, you can just buy the PIS sensor. Almost all PIS sensor is the same, and also you can just take out your PIS sensor and then you just read the A number. So for example, this is A20214059. I bet yours is the same PIS sensor. Now we push the printhead carriage all the way to the left. So on the right, we can lift it up and moving the metal bar to the right a little bit. And now we can lift it and take the PIS sensor out. Don't forget, the blue side of the FFC cable is towards the sky, it is up. And now we insert a new PIS sensor and tuck it underneath. And put that little screw to secure the PIS sensor. You want to line up the holes on the plastic base first, and then slide the metal to the right. If you can't, just move your printhead carriage to the middle and push from the left. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at www.bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.